Hello and welcome, lovely, amazing video game type people, to the gaming event of the century. The first wonderful game of 2015 that I'm looking forward to playing, and it just came out on GOG, and I want to try it, and it's called Avernum Crystal Souls. So, let's get right into it. And by let's get right into it, I do mean do this. Come to the bottom here. Click on the tips for getting started. I'm going to read this to you out loud. Your nice new party is getting stomped again and again. It's humiliating. You can't find anything good to fight. The monsters are slaughtering you. You can't get money. What can you do? Don't give up. It works with the music quite nicely. Don't give up. This chapter contains some good advice for getting started and a walkthrough and hints for getting through the demo. There is hope. 1. Be sure to search all of the rooms and containers in the Fort Ganrick. Lots of supplies have been left for you. 2. At early levels, magic will keep you alive. Use Bless and Haste spells and get a character who can cast Icy Rain as soon as possible. Spells that damage an area are strong. 3. Some skills are more important than others for building strong parties. The melee and pole weapon skill increase your damage output by lots of it for your melee fighters. Spellcraft makes every spell you cast more effective. 4. In general, your wizards will do more damage and your warriors will keep the monsters from killing your wizards. Get used to putting your warriors in front to grab the attention of monsters. Have your priests and mages stand back and heal. Bless and haste the warriors. 5. If you are still being overwhelmed, chip away at the dungeons. Duck in, kill a few enemies, and run back to the city gates to rest. Or, if worst comes to worst, you can reduce the game difficulty level in the setting window. 6. Change the difficulty to casual on the options window or use the character editor. This is a far better option than getting stuck and not having any fun. Wonderful, awesome, exciting. Let's party. Real quick catch up for anyone who's missed it, who's been living under a rock, who's been living in the caves of exile. I call it exile. This game series is by Spiderweb Software, one of my favorite companies, by a guy called Jeff Vogel. He's pretty awesome. He made the series Exile 1, 2, 3, the original Exile series. One of the best, most unique stories I've ever heard. It's wonderful. Well, then later, he did a remake of that series, turned it into a sort of 3D thing from the original 2D, called it Avernum. Avernum 1, 2, and 3. He then did an Avernum 4, 5, and 6. And then he went on and did other things like Geneforge, which we all know, and Abaddon as well. And now, recently, since since finishing Geneforge and while doing Abaddon 1 and Abaddon 2, now he's been working on kind of a second remake of the remake of Exile. So what he's doing is he's updating it, making them look beautiful, adding a few extra things. Pretty exciting. Let's see how this turns out. Crystal Souls is the second in the series. After the first one, I believe canonically, you assassinate Emperor Hawthorne, ergo the Empire comes... It's kind of the Empire Strikes Back. So now the Caves of Exile, and I guess in this case Avernum, are being attacked by the Empire, and all seems lost and doomed. And that's where we come in. So welcome to Avernum. Avernum 2 is a fantasy role-playing game. You will control a band of wandering adventurers, meeting strange people, fighting monsters, and trying to survive. Select the sort of characters you would like to play. If you aren't sure, just take the party that's already been created for you. When you're ready, press the OK button. Great. Good. Love it. Okay, so yeah, basically what we want to do is, yeah, a priest, a mage, and two warriors. That seems pretty legitimate. Okay, there's the bonuses based on race. I'd like to have one of each. I think that's kind of neat. Bonus trait every 4 levels. Human sounds nice. Plus 10 to missile damage and cold resistance. Pretty pathetic. Slith, not bad if we use a pole character. For variety's sake, let's do it. I'm not going to super power game this. I would like to play it on hard, though. Oh. These are all the characters. Guess that hasn't really changed much, has it? Oh, a ninja. I think Eldis. That's Eldis? Okay. So, new character type. Let's look at the character types right now and see what's going on here. I probably won't do custom. Soldiers received excellent military training on the surface, the best the Empire had to offer. They're very good with all sorts of weapons. Ugh, that seems pathetic. It seems absolutely awful to start as a soldier, because then you have melee weapons and pole weapons, which makes no sense. You should pick one. Berserkers are wild swordsmen from the remote areas of the Empire. Their wildness tends to get them dumped into Avernum. They're extremely hardy, and their sword skill is unmatched. Okay, see, that's more interesting. I'm more interested in a berserker, because obviously melee weapons is quite high there. So that's good for a sword wielder, not a pole. Those are the two weapons, right? Swords and poles. Pole arms. A priest of one of the faiths disapproved of by the Empire. They have excellent healing and protective skills, although they often end up having to use them in Avernum. Not bad, not bad. Yeah. First aid, arcane lore, and priest spells. None of these are wasted, really. Thrown missiles, maybe. But the other things are fine. Sorcerers are practitioners of the wizardly arts. Their spells are powerful, both on offense and defense. Alas, because of their dangerous research and eccentricities, they tend to be sent down to Avernum. Boom! Mage spells are not bad, not bad. Bows, not quite sure why, but okay. Rogue. Rogues are nimble, good with swords, and able to handle locks and traps. Okay, that's interesting. They also tend to walk off with things they don't own. Unsurprisingly, the Empire loves to send them to Avernum. Now, that's interesting. Might just go for a rogue instead of a berserker. That seems handy. Archer. Archers were either hunters or trained members of the Empire Army, highly skilled with missile weapons in the Empire Army. A dishonorable discharge tends to mean exile to Avernum. Now, last time I remember, in the first Avernum remake, so the one immediately prior to this, second remake of Exile, Avernum, Escape from the Pit, that's what it's called, it just doesn't work out that well. Archery, I mean. But let's assume that everything's going to work out fine. What do we got here? Archer, yeah. Rebel. Some people dare to rebel against the Empire. They have to be good at everything if they want to survive, though they don't have the freedom to excel at one thing. Okay, a rebel tends to have some skill with weapons, traps, and lore. So just super broadly general, not very good. Hedge wizard. Hedge wizards live in the remote villages of the Empire where they help the locals with their magical skills. This sort of character is good at magery and has a little bit of training in priest spells and first aid. Oh, awkward. So that's really awkward. Shaman. Shamans are the priests of the back hills. A shaman isn't quite as good at spells as a priest, but makes up for it with weaponry and knowledge of healing. Shamans are hardy folk, but their wildness tends to make them run afoul of the Empire. Ugh, just awkward. Okay. Oh, goodness. Horum. Okay, here's what I'm thinking. No, we're not going to make you a soldier. Either a berserker. Yeah. Need to be a berserker or a rogue. I'd like to try a rogue. Let's try a rogue. Which means you can go ahead and look cooler than that. We need a good roguely character. That's quite roguish. Roguish. I guess, whatever, you look roguish enough. Change name. Aiden shall be our rogue. Okay. Rebel, hey? I don't think we liked the Rebel class. Once again, very, all over the place, not very good. Though pole arms, that's interesting. Might have to end up going with that, if none of the others have pole arms. Really? None of you guys? No? Nobody wants pole arms? Okay, looks like it's gonna be Rebel. Yay. Pretty pathetic, but we'll boost up his pole arms pretty quick there then. I guess it sort of makes sense. Anybody of these guys? What's this one? The Shaman? Strength, intelligence, endurance, pole weapons, thrown missiles, pre-spells, cave lore. I mean, that's pretty awkward. But I'm interested in the idea of having a sort of awkward Shaman. Weaponry and knowledge of healing. Okay. I'm sure we could try that. There's the pole weapons there anyway, right? So really awful priest spells and pole weapon fighting. Sort of makes sense. Rogue, shaman, priest, sorcerer. Ooh. New character type. Yeah, sorcerer will work. Yes, sorcerer will work. But my question is this, then, if the sorcerer has the bow, why not make the Nephil the sorcerer, right? Absolutely makes more sense. Because if I look at the priest, there's nothing. There's thrown missiles, but that's not doing anything for me. So, you get to be the sorcerer. We have a Nephil sorcerer. And you get to be the priest. Let's try that. Okay. Rogue, shaman, sorcerer, priest. I have no idea if this is going to work. This is going to be insane. Yeah, this is going to be absolutely insane. This probably will not work at all. Human, slith, Nephil, human. I'm fine with that. Okay. There's got to be someone a little bit... Okay, perfect. Yeah, she's cute. Let's go with her. Okay, you get to be... what's a good name? Alora. I recently liked that name. Alora the Priest. Okay, what do our Sith look like? Oh, I like that one. Yeah, that looks good. Just a total tough guy shaman. Zessos. That's okay. Wonder if we can give him a kind of anglicized name. Horum the Sorcerer. Oh, that's not so bad. I don't like that one. That's like heavily armored. It looks like a rogue. I think that's decent. Okay. Aiden, Zessos, Horum, and Alora. Horum. Zessos. That'll do. I'm totally down with this. Let's party. Boom! And we're gonna try... oh, I want to do normal. The game starts out quite easy, but becomes a challenge as you get close to the end. A nice moderate difficulty level. Oh, harder difficulty setting for the more experienced gamer. Your foes will do more damage and be a lot harder to kill. Okay, let's try hard, and I'm not going to be averse to stepping down the difficulty, okay? We'll start on hard. If things get ridiculous, I will step back to normal. Here goes, folks. Avernum is the underworld. It is a series of hundreds of miles of caves far below the surface of the world. The land is kept alive and fruitful by powerful magic and the heat and energy of natural steam vents and hot springs. Avernum is also a nation. It is a land of people exiled from the surface world. The surface is ruled by the Empire, an all-powerful nation who disposed of unwanted people by banishing them to Avernum. Oh, it looks beautiful. They formed a new nation far from the eyes of the Empire. Some, however, were not satisfied with safety and peace. They wished vengeance. They sent a band of assassins to slay Hawthorne, cruel emperor of the Empire. The Empire was stunned. They realized that there was a den of vipers, threatening their sole control of the globe. They had no other possible response. They invaded. Oh, snap. Yeah, it's never a good time when the Empire invades. They're terrifying. The power of the Empire completely dwarfed that of the Avernites, but it had great difficulty teleporting troops to the underworld. The Empire arrogantly thought that Avernum could be subdued with a few hundred elite troops. The Empire sent more troops down, but the Avernites kept them at bay. The Empire grew frustrated and angry, and then it turned to terror and atrocity, and slowly it ground away at Avernum's defenses. Ooh, good. Avernum also had the advantage of familiarity. They were used to living and fighting in caves. The Empire wasn't. The Empire's soldiers were fought to a bloody standstill. Little by little, cave by cave, the invaders won victories against Avernum. Then, when things looked like they couldn't get any worse, a new disaster occurred. Magical barriers appeared all over Avernum, splitting it into small sections and blocking all roads. Nobody knew who made these barriers. Maybe the Empire, maybe not. Just as the barriers appeared, you arrived at your first posting. You have just joined the army of Avernum, eager to join the good fight. Your dreams of heroism were short-lived. You were sent to Fort Ganrick, a tiny, unfinished outpost in the far northeast corner of Avernum. Ooh. You dream of great victories, of deeds that turn the tide and save your homeland. Instead, you reported to Captain Vidikin and were put to work digging out storerooms. Fort Ganrick isn't ready for warfare. Yet. Each morning, you wake up in a damp cave, looking forward to a long day of shovels and picks. It's hard to imagine anything that could happen, which would enable you to strike a mighty blow against the Empire. Boom! Pretty epic. Alright. Welcome to Avernum. These caverns are a tutorial to help you get started. First, you need to learn how to move around. Click on a spot on the ground to walk there. Okay. Oh, look, they walk. How odd. I'm not used to that. Whatever, looks cool. Okay, let's get things. G. I have that in my pack. There's a blanket on the ground. Okay. Let's get out of the dank cave. You stumble groggily out of the cave that has been your unwilling home for several weeks. Your muscles are still sore from yesterday's digging. You've been working on these storage tunnels for weeks. You notice that the gate to the north is closed. Most Avernites have learned to resist claustrophobia, but seeing your lone route to the exit closed off makes you nervous. You can see Maxine on the other side. Maybe she knows what is happening. Before you proceed further, however, you should protect your head with a helmet. Two crude helms of thick lizard skin wait for you on the table nearby. You should take advantage of them before you move on. If you must know, I'm drinking wonderfully delicious coffee right now. Okay, there's the... oh, poor leather helmet. Love it. Boom. Oh, Yeah, there you go. You can just use the 1, 2, 3, 4 button on your keyboard to jump around the characters, and also if you pick up an item and then hit the number, it'll automatically go to that character. So how are we doing here? This is our sorcerer, I believe? Yeah, sorcerer, priest, shaman. I don't know what I was thinking with the whole shaman thing, but we'll see. The lizard skin helm is crude and dirty, but it will keep falling stones from cracking your precious skull bones. You look with regret at the door to the south. Time to start digging. Ugh. I'm going to talk to Maxine. You look through the gate and see Maxine hard at work. She is a skilled stoneworker sent into Avernum not long before the Empire invaded. Her skin still shows a tiny remnant of color from being in the sun. She is behind the closed gate, fixing some blocks in the frame with mortar. She nods and smiles when she sees you. Sorry, trapped you in there. Won't be long. At least you can dig uninterrupted. Tell me about yourself, Maxine. I'm not a big soldier like you. Just another unfortunate who said the wrong thing, got the wrong man angry, and was sent down here. What? What did you say to get sent down here? She frowns and suddenly becomes very distracted by her bucket of mortar. In Avernum, asking how you got sent into the underworld is poor manners. Ah, that's fair. I guess it makes sense, isn't it? It's kind of like you start a new life, you know? So, why did you come to Fort Ganrick? I had to help out somewhere, and I had skills to use. This fort needs to be finished. Once I was down here, your war against the Empire became my war. All right, I'd like to ask something else. I can't stop you. You're on the other side of the gate. What's happening with this gate? I just need to close it for a few minutes to place this frame. Won't be long. Take your time. Oh, it won't be long. Why don't you go do your digging? Looks like you only have a few more years of it to go. Ha! Thanks. Jerk. Da-da-da. You enter the room you've spent several weeks expanding. Your worn tools wait on the floor, promising exhausting hours of chipping away at one of Avernum's unending walls. However, things do not go as planned. As you enter the cave, the ground shakes under your feet. Slightly, at first. Then harder. It doesn't feel like one of Avernum's many cave quakes. No, this is more local. And then you hear cracking stone, and a cloud of dust pours out of the passage to the south. Then you hear the chattering of shrill voices. Something has dug its way into your fort. You're about to enter combat mode. Once battle has begun, to attack an enemy, select the space it is standing in. You will also get tips about spells and abilities you can use. Uh-oh. I feel like we're in trouble. Whoa, special encounter. How to attack? To attack this foe, select the space it is standing in. You are now in combat. Characters will take turns moving and attacking. Each turn you get a few action points. Everything you do, moving, using items, attacking, etc., costs action points. When you run out, your turn is over. To attack a foe, select the space it is standing in. The space your cursor is over will be tinted red. If there is an enemy in that space, it will glow. Oh, that sounds cool. Okay. Warriors can use battle disciplines to harm foes. Why not try it? Press the button to use a discipline. Okay. Press this button to select well-aimed blow, then attack a foe. The attack will do extra damage. Using a battle discipline fatigues you for a short time. When you use discipline, you won't be able to use another for several turns. Great. Well, let's test it out then. So, let's go ahead. Kill the goblin. Awful. Okay. So you should be able to fight. Oh, just a crude dagger. That's pretty pathetic. But that's not bad. We're kind of blocking that. Let's see. Priest spells. Smite. Protection. Curing. Minor heal. Okay, we'll do a quick protection. That's cool. It got everyone except for Alora because of the walls. You know, walls block magic. This is our sorcerer. You can use magic to destroy your foes. Why not try it? Press this button to cast a mage spell. Press this button to select Bolt of Fire, then click on a target to cast the spell. Casting spells uses up your spell energy. Your spell energy is restored when you return to a friendly town. Oh, thank you. What's Cloak of Curses? Okay, random curse with every attack. Dazed is super wonderful. So we're going to Bolt of Fire a guy. Goblin Flinger, Goblin, Goblin. Okay, the Goblin Flinger is the one we want to hurt. Oh, right, we are on hard difficulty, so it's going to be a little bit tougher. We're going to go ahead and use Smite with this one. We want to kill the archer. Whoa. Okay, I'm going to see if I can... Yeah, you can totally use your number pad as well, which is pretty awesome. Okay. You have a wounded character. Now is a good time to try a healing spell. Press this button to cast a priest spell. I'm not going to heal someone right now. Same idea, minor heal, heals an ally. No. Dead Goblin Flinger. Love it. Okay. Dead Goblin. Okay. Really? Interesting. Just use space. Critical. Did no damage. Oh, good. Suppose I step away. Enemy slows you down. That's okay. There we go. That's what I wanted. Backstab. Interesting. I'd almost forgotten he's a rogue. So, ergo, he's going to get extra damage every time. Ooh, that was a dirty hit. Every time he attacks someone standing next to someone else. See? Backstab. Nice. Boom. I wonder if there's a way to speed up the animations. Settings. Background sounds, sound volume, walk animation, snap movement, animated. Yeah, let's do snap movement and see if that does anything. Uh-huh. Boom. Okay. Probably not, but... Boom. Let's get a nice little, I'm going to use MAA. That's great. And you're going to use PA1. Nice. Goblins are a perpetual pest in the underworld. Simple-minded, violent, enthusiastic breeders. It's far from the first time you have had to fight them. However, they are very disorganized. It looks like they've been working on digging this little tunnel for weeks. Goblins never engage in such sustained project unless someone much more powerful forces them. You suddenly have a very bad feeling. You need to walk out of the main fort and let them know what is happening. Now that battle is over, press the end combat button to go back to traveling as a group. There you go. Or the F key. Boom. Peace. Okay. What can we get on the ground? Wooden shield. I'll take it. Thank you. 8% chance to parry. Encumbers mages. Minus 10% to hit chance. So it's kind of like you hit better with less defense. Pretty standard in this game. Okay, we'll definitely take the crude javelins. I think they're handy dandy. We'll give them to this guy. Boom. Just to see what happens. Excuse me. Oh! Here's a chest. Sure. Take some food with you. Might as well. Let's go right in here, actually, and take all the healing potions and put them in the quick item slots. And you get to take some food, too. Alright. Okay, nothing this way. Nothing this way. Well, suppose that's that. Grab some sandals. Unsurprisingly, the dead goblins were not the only threat. The sounds of battle echo from the north. Happily, Maxine managed to get the gate open so you can reach the carnage that much more quickly. Something terrible is happening. As you approach the gate, a wall to the east collapses. A goblin head timidly pokes out of the wreckage, looking for victims. When he sees you, he ducks back and calls gleefully to his fellows. Oh, ha, ha. Wait, from where? Oh, from there. Oh, okay. Well, then we're going to get into position. Start hitting y'all folks. I should switch it up so that he attacks second, so that he can get the bonus on the very first go. Nice. Is there no one else? Is there no one else? Oh, hello. There is else. Okay. Wait with you. You get to come here. Do a lovely... goblin warrior, goblin, yeah. Start chipping down the goblin warrior before he gets to us. Protection's always a happy time. Oops, my bad. Parry, that's pleasant. You're gonna hit the goblin warrior again? Oh, and you missed with a 90% chance. That's unfortunate. Nice. Okay. Okay. Very pleasant. Let's see, another crude dagger. Value 20. So this is where we're gonna. I'm gonna hold down Control and click on it, and it's gonna go in my junk bag. Okay, and that's items that I'd like to sell. Good, 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 good. Take some crude javelins. Alright, that's pleasant. We're doomed! No, Maxine, we're not doomed! Maxine has dropped her tools and is wandering around dazed, not sure what is happening. You remember that she isn't a soldier, just a stonemason, trapped in a terrible place. She looks at you. What? What is happening? Are we being attacked? It's just goblins, not a problem. But I heard more fighting towards the exit. It can't just be goblins. Okay, I'll say something like, you should leave these tunnels. I don't think so. I'm going to hide down here. Unless more of them dig out, then I don't know. She crouches and buries her face in her hands. Oh, Maxine, okay. The storeroom is a large natural cave you discovered while digging passages in the rock behind the fort. Finding it was a huge relief. It saved you a lot of work. The passageway down to the rest of the fort is to the north. This is a good time, if you haven't already, to save your game. Okay. We're gonna save the game here. Just call it Exile. That's what the game is really called. Da-da-da. You hear shouting and running to the north, and then two Avernite soldiers run into the storeroom in a panic. They are new arrivals like you, green enough to be terrified of the goblins that are chasing them. Oh, good. Oh, come on, guys. Are you serious right now? You're supposed to be helping me fight. Okay, goblin, 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 goblin warrior, goblin flinger. Okay, we can deal with this. Let's start by blocking off this path. Okay. Enemy slows you down. That's unfortunate. Okay. Let's see what we can do here. Ooh. Uh-huh. Uh-oh. Goblin warrior got in. It's okay. Oops. Really? Oh! Okay, we're gonna wanna do something about that. Mm-hmm. Okay, and we're gonna heal. That's pleasant. Okay, go easy, folks. Go easy. Okay, that's pleasant. Now we're gonna go to you, and again, heal. Okay, hit the goblin. Wow, these guys hit hard. Love how helpful those soldiers are being down there. Total jerks. Man, if goblins are this hard, I'm worried about the rest of the game. Yeah! Let's get a smite in. Oh, that is a goblin flinger. Total jerk. Oops! What? What? I didn't want that. Did I hit W? Oh, W, world map. Okay, we're right there. We're the crossed axes. That's cool. Okay, I actually just want to... Oh, shortcut S. Switch weapons. Let's see what happens. Nice. That does a lot of damage. We'd best keep those for tough combats. Fort Ganrick, how to use items. To use an item, press the sun symbol in the corner. You can also put the item in a quick use slot to access it quickly. You've reached the completed storerooms and are pleased to find that some of the supplies are still here. Considering how little the castle sent out here, even before the barriers blocked travel, this is a stroke of luck. One healing potion sits on the table in the alcove to the south, waiting for some lucky warrior to claim it. Okay, good, good. That sounds wonderful. I think we can stop fighting. Alchemical equipment, grab it. Healing potion, grab it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Crude javelins, let's... Give the crude javelins to... Oh no, you get a bow, friend. You're my archer sorcerer, aren't you? Which means crude javelins go to the priest. Everybody's got crude javelins. This one has a bow. You don't need arrows. Arrows are unlimited. So that's cool. The original exile, you needed arrows. So that was also problematic. But not so bad. You could get cooler arrows and whatnot, I think. Arrows of demon slaying, that sort of thing. So that's unfortunate that that's gone now. You see a bow and javelins on the table to the north. They are crude and heavily used, perhaps dating to the earliest days of Avernum. When you attack an enemy, you will use your default weapon. This can be a melee weapon, sword or spear, or a missile weapon, javelin or bow. Get the javelins and equip them. You can switch your default weapon by pressing the buttons to the lower left or by typing S. You can skip a character turn in combat by clicking on it or pressing the space bar. Cool. And I just did that, so... You guys saw that? That was cool. Man, I should just take that mortar and pestle. Oh, look at this. Horarum. Isn't that, like, my guy's name? What's my guy's name? Horum. Horum and Horarum. Oh, good. Okay. Hey! Found a crude spear. That's exciting. Boom! Oh, we can... Get out! You can't dual-wield when you have a two-handed weapon equipped. I did not realize dual-wielding was a thing. That's very exciting. Okay, group heal. You go ahead and take that. That's going to be very useful. Someday. There's water here. That's nice. Oh, there's goblins and Horarum. Okay. This is going to be interesting. The stairs down to the rest of Fort Ganrick are to the south, but they are guarded. You see the foes waiting to ambush you, and you immediately realize who is behind the assault. The goblins here are led by a Nephil warrior. The Nephilim are a race of fierce, clannish feline warriors. The Empire has slaughtered most of their number, sending a few survivors down to Avernum. Of late, the Avernites have made peace with some of their clans, but others remain determined to get revenge on humanity. The large hunter snarls and hisses when he sees you. Murder! It is luck! Human prey for Horarum of the Fang Clan! Easy prey!
Oh, ho, ho, ho! You think I am easy prey?
Warriors of this fort are dregs. They run when we come. We hunt you all and take fort for our own. First victory for Fang Clan.
Okay.
How about this? Leave now and you can live. Horarum bares his teeth and lets out a long hiss. Flee! At our moment of triumph? Never! He leaps ahead of the goblins, eager to claim his prey.
Oh, good. Okay. So, I'm gonna see if I can actually switch the roster real quick. Since the game hasn't put us into combat mode yet. How do I? There we go. Hey, that's exciting. Okay. Hold down tab. Okay, so if he's gonna leap forward, I'm going to assume... Not quite sure how to go about this then. We're probably gonna die here. Let's all fall back into defensive positions here. Alright, we're going to defend. Aiden is going to stand there. And shoot at Horarum. Not bad. Oh, he's immobile. What? That's wonderful. Apparently that shot was much better than I originally anticipated. Let's hit him with a daze. Might as well. To demonstrate the most useful spell in the game. Okay, everybody lost a turn. So that's absolutely amazing. And that gives us a chance. So he's still immobile, though. So that's pleasant. Let's all rip into this guy. Since that tends to do a lot of damage. Let's test out our bow skill. Not bad. Oh, he's immobile again. Oh, good. Okay. He'll be dead soon. Really, guys, I must protest. There we go, smite seems to be pretty useful. These guys still dazed? Wow. Alright, you can... Oh, I keep hitting W. It used to be W, I think.
Horarum falls to the ground dead. He is far from the first to fatally underestimate the warriors of Avernum. You open the leather satchel hanging from his belt. Inside it, you find two scrolls. One of them is inscribed with magical runes. The other looks like a map. Interesting. You set the map aside, hoping to read it when the chaos has died down. To read a map, use it in your inventory. Cool. Medal earned. The ambush. Look at that. Medal. It's like achievements on Steam. Wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful. We're going to have to do something about these guys.
Boom!
He's no longer dazed. It seems like a poor life decision, but okay.
Critical. That was great. All right, you can just jump ahead. Da 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 da. Another shield chant. Oh, good. Okay. And we're gonna hit S, switch you to your pole arm. Whoa, nice hit. That is very juicy. Love what's happening here. Okay, you can take that shot. Parry again. Great. Okay, you're gonna... Oh, terrified. He's dead terrified. Get that backstab as well. Shoot it in. Oh, we're doing great. Priest, finish the job. Nice. Alright, we got some leather pants. Woot, woot. Not even the Slitzerikai, wise as they are, have discovered the joy to be found in a truly well-tailored pair of pants. Funny, though, because they just have. I mean, this guy has. Zessos has just done that. Silver necklace, that's just money. So we're going to do crude javelin. We're going to pass that over to this guy. Okay, crude javelin again. Crude javelin again. Broken clay, we don't need a chainmail vest. Love it. Absolutely love it. We're going to throw that on. Yeah. It's going to increase his defense. Right? Anything that increases armor, good thing for our main tank. Our main tank rogue. As awkward as that seems. Okay. The door to the east is held shut by a padlock. That explains why goblins haven't looted it yet. If you pick the lock, you might be able to take advantage of Fort Ganrick's limited supplies. Tool use skill determines what doors you can open. Each lock and trap has a difficulty number attached to it. If the tool use in your party is at least as high as the difficulty, you can bypass it. Oh, no! Oh, my tool use isn't high enough. That's stupid. I swear we have a tool use, don't we? We have two tool use. Come on. Terrible. The Wookiees disagree. That was my ringtone. At last you have found the path down to Fort Ganrick. The sounds of battle are still audible ahead, and you cannot tell whether the humans or Nephilim are winning. You take a moment to rest, and then you ready your weapons. Perhaps a few additional swords on the Avernite side can turn the tide of the battle. Step on the sloped floor to go downstairs. So there you go, folks. Very exciting thus far. I'm going to end this episode here on a nice little cliffhanger for you. And next time you get to see us join an epic fight, I'm assuming there's going to be lots of Avernite soldiers, and it's going to be tough and painful and devastating, and everyone's going to die. So, cool. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Avernum 2. Crystal Souls. That's right. Bye!